76 million of us just here in the US. We are the biggest generation that ever existed. We were called the me ones, the crazy ones, and boy, do we know what that means, don't we? In fact, we have reinvented every single phase of our life. We were the yuppies, we were the hippies, we like innovation. Well, now we are in the winter of our life, and I can assure you, this is not going to be your average winter. I invite you to join me at Boomerology Reviews every single week so we can figure out how boomers are reshaping this phase of their lives. Join me. On this episode of Boomerology Reviewed, I interview Chris Miller, author and speaker, talking about getting ready for pre-retirement. Yes, I know we don't want to retire, but have we taken care of our finances? Can we start after 50 and, you know, really feel safe later in life? We are going to see that. And I'm going to show you how Procter & Gamble used an ad they used 40 years ago, revamped to cater to the values of boomers today. It's really, really interesting. Let's watch. Chris Miller is a speaker and author of the book, Ready for Pre-Retirement, Three Secrets for Save Money and a Fabulous Future. Welcome, Chris.
Thank you for having me.
Chris, before we go into the topic, I would like to know a little bit about you and why you decided on this journey.
Well, to make a long story short, as a paralegal, I used to volunteer at retirement centers and help people with living trusts and estate planning. And when I saw little widows being taken advantage of and being charged $5,000, $20,000 for a little trust, I was outraged. So I decided I was going to make it easy for the average person to get a living trust. And I'm one of the first people in Southern California to do workshops on the difference between trusts. Then my business developed and I noticed that people were losing their money in the stock market. People were losing their money in long-term care and catastrophic illness. So I really focused on this and drilled down and found out a lot of secrets. Or they're not secrets, people just don't know about these tools.
When we look at numbers, we see that most baby boomers are really not prepared for retirement.
AARP did a survey, and 63% of people are more afraid of running out of money than they are dying.
Wow.
And basically half the population maybe has 2 months of money to live on. A lot of people are just not ready. So, yeah, it definitely needs to be on everybody's mind because we're in a different economy. The model has changed. Now it's about safe money and tax deferral and ways that you can get an income for life.
But do you believe that, for example, us boomers, they are 50 and older, is there still time for us?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, I even work with people 90 years old.
Wow.
But, of course, I found out in my late 50s, revealing my age, because we're as young as we think, not as we feel, right?
Very true.
But I found out about a tool that was for people that are 34 to 54, and I didn't even find out about it till my late 50s. This information is actually withheld from the average person because, you know, a broker makes a lot more money gambling your money in the stock market, right, than the safe money strategies.
Give us some strategies for people that are 50 and over. Let's say we are part of those 63%. We have not prepared before. So what can we do?
Okay. Well, a lot of people have IRAs, right, retirement accounts. So let's just say you had a retirement account, and more than likely that account is in the stock market. You probably lost 40 to 60% in the last crash. Maybe you're back to where you were, so you lost 7-8 years, and you're really nowhere. So the point is, there's actually a place, and this is what I've done with my money. I've actually showing people what I own. And I've rolled my money out of the stock market in what's called a tax-deferred an income annuity with an index. It's an income annuity. And what it does is it gets the growth of the index of the stock market without risking your principal. So that's why I can proudly say I have never lost $1 of my clients' money in 23 years. And I've counseled over 5,000 people. So I use a safe money strategy. And the tax-deferred annuity with the income rider, now get ready for this, actually gives you 7% interest compounded on an income you will never outlive.
Wow.
It's really amazing, yes.
But does this require to play big when I go that route or not?
You play with what you have. I mean, if you only have, you know, $20,000, that's what you have. But you roll it over, you make a 10% bonus, and you start adding 7%. You get something rather than nothing or losing money. These accounts never go down. They only go up. There's a bottom on it. So it only rises. And there's an income account and a growth account. These are super for retirement.
Even if we don't understand anything about stock market, that's not a problem, right?
Absolutely, because I want you to not understand the stock market, because I want you to be out of there. You know, that's really why I wrote my book, and I put my business in the book. I want to empower people to understand. See, because what I saw in two decades is that people come in at 70 and 80, and then I'll go, where's your IRA? And they'll go, at the bank. And I go, where at the bank? And they don't really understand money. And that's intentional because, you know, the information has been withheld from people. So that's why I put it in the book, because I want people to understand this safe money strategy. So the by the time you're done with me, you will actually be able to share it with someone else. And I make it really simple. What I do is I offer people what's called a financial fitness exam. And I look at what you have and where it is according to your age, health, and wealth. Then I will show you the safe money strategies on what I'm talking about and how they all work.
Now, you told me about people, they don't understand the money language, right?
Right.
Can you tell me a few points that we should be aware of?
What happens is we all go to school, we learn how to make money, we get out of school, you make money, and then what? Most people go to a broker. Most people don't really like their broker. And what does he do? He gambles your money in Las Vegas. I mean, Wall Street, right? It's a gamble. And the problem is that if you end up and retire, say you retire at 65, 70, you go reach in to get your money and the market's down, you've really lost. So that's the problem with that market, is it goes up and down. We're in some very volatile times. So the idea is to get your money safe. Get it in a place where you could get the growth of the market without risking your principal. So an equity index annuity is an amazing place to do that. So I don't really put my principal in the market. I get the growth of the market on that investment.
When we are talking about retirement and I go and apply this strategy, how many years do you think until I feel safe?
Well, I'll tell you what, $1 million is not a lot of money. Seriously, you've got to be over safe. You really have to be proactive and start it, because there's other things than just losing money in the stock market. There's health issues. There's long-term care. 7 out of 10 of us over 65 end up in a nursing home, and those run $170 to $500 a day, and your health insurance doesn't cover it. Medicare doesn't cover it, and people don't understand this. But it is a nightmare. I'll never forget the look on my mom's face. She came up to me and she handed me this paper. She had a big tear in her eye. And I went, what, Mom? And I looked at it. She goes, maybe you can help your clients. It was a bill from Stanford Hospital for 5 days of chemo. Guess how much it was?
Unbelievable amount.
Unbelievable. $90,000 for 5 days. And she had it 5 days a month for a year. So $1 million is not a lot of money. My parents didn't have long-term care insurance. They had to pay for it all out of the pocket. My mom's home care, full-time home care, $15,000 a month. It's insane. My dad is 94 and a half. Thank God he's still alive. But we had to get home care for him. Mm-hmm. And that cost, and I made a deal, and it's still $70,000 a year.
Wow. Yeah, you hear many, many horror stories, really, of families that go bankrupt when something happens, for example, with health. But on the other side, Chris, we also hear quite often that we don't like to think about this time in our lives, right? When a health issue comes. What do you think?
Plan retirement early so your money, your health, and your peace of mind is there when you need it. So what I encourage, I have a radio show called Ready, Set, Retire, but I change the word retire to refire. So when you turn 50, you recreate yourself. because I use 100 or 105 as the goal. So you recreate yourself with your second life. How are you going to give back to the world? What's your expertise? What is it that you can share with others to help give back? And so the way I look at turning 50 is, okay, now you start your second life. And I get up every morning and I thank God for being alive. And I look at it like, okay, the older I get, the younger I feel up here, right? It is a mindset. It's a state of mind. So you can change all that by the way you think.
Chris, in 2008, I had some clients that they were around 70, and they did lose most of their money in the stock market, right? It was a very sad period of time. Well, can we follow your strategies? For example, if we found ourselves now struggling on the day-to-day life, we don't have any more money aside as we used to, or not? Yes. This is just for people that were able to save something.
No, absolutely. I work with all people with all amounts of money, you know, from being in debt to people that have over $10 million. So the point is that, you know, if people are in debt, then I show them programs on how to get out of debt or you know, it's surprising how much discretionary money people have. They don't realize when you write down everything you spend and how many times you went to Starbucks and how many dinners you go out and have. People have a lot more stashed away than they think. Of course, I realize there are some that are really having a hard time. But yes, I work with all people, and if I can't work with you, I just tell you, this wouldn't work for you. You know, I don't need to sell things to make money. I really want to serve people and help them get what will help them, which is the best thing.
Can you give me two tips that people can use to get ready, at least to have a picture of how their situation is?
So I have a workbook that actually has a little step-by-step instructions and things that you need to even know about that you don't even think about. You can get that at PretirementSecrets.com, and that's PretireMent.com, secrets. Or you can text 7777 at 22828. And then that way you can get that copy. Right here and now, I'll give you a couple tips. If you own a home, you have kids, you need to make sure you have the right kind of legal documents. You need a living trust to avoid probate. You need powers of attorney while you're alive for financial, for health care, guardianships for any minor children. It shocks me how many parents don't even think about if they go out to dinner and don't come back, who's going to take care of the kids. So all of the right, you need to have all those right legal documents, and we prepare trusts for everybody all over the United States. We've made thousands of them. So you need your right legal documents. You need to look into long-term care if you're 50 and above. You need to make sure your money is safe. You've got a bottom on your money before the next crash, and it's coming soon. So if you don't understand that, you're welcome to reach out to me so I can explain to how that relates to your age, your health, and your wealth.
When we have aging parents, like yourself, right, this conversation can be tricky. How do you think we should approach with our aging parents this kind of, you know, it's a difficult topic. I would say it's almost as difficult as talking about sex sometimes, right?
You know, our parents were in the generation that a will was the way you left everything to your family. Mm-hmm. They don't even know what a trust is. So when you approach them, they're, oh, no, I've got everything done. Or they're not open to, you know, receive. I have videos and things that I share with people that you can sit down with your parents and go, let's watch this video. And then they can understand what the difference is between a will and a trust and why it's so important to have long-term care insurance.
Now, tell me a little bit about your radio show.
Well, my radio show called Ready, Set, Retire, but none of us like that word retire. And honestly, I'm going to work to 105. Now, my dad worked to 91, and he wouldn't have stopped if he hadn't fell, but he fell and he broke his femur bone, and the rest is history. So he had to get, you know, care after that. But I invite all kinds of amazing guests because pre-retirement isn't just about money. It's about your state of mind. It's about your health, your wealth. And so my show is on webtalkradio.org. It's syndicated on Stitcher. But what I was finding was so many people hate the word retire that I decided I'd change it to refire because That's what you do. When you turn 50, refire your life and look at how you can give back and share and make the world a better place.
Right, and I like the idea, as you mentioned, of reinventing yourself, right? We easily have 50 more years ahead of us, so yeah, why not? Why not start a new process and really change some paradigms related to money? I think the money mindset, how do you see that, the money mindset of most baby boomers? Are they in the right place or not?
Oh, no. I only, you know, maybe 1% of people I run into are in the right place. There's so much fear and emotion and, my husband always banked at Bank of America. I'll never change. Or I even see that in myself with all of my, quote, enlightenment, right? I'll see my, I don't want to sell that stock. My dad told me to get that. Or maybe it's bad, you know. So we all get emotionally involved. And there's a lot of fear because we don't know how to trust God, trust the Spirit, that everything will come to us. So we're always trying to manage everything ourselves instead of taking thought and trusting the Spirit. So there is a lot of mindset. And I find I do a lot of counseling with people. I have couples come in that have never talked to each other about money. And I end up doing a lot of counseling with them about, because there's so much fear involved with all of it. But you've got to get your money mindset right. You better talk to your spouse or your significant other or your family or your friends and say, something happens to me, here's my emergency money, or this is what we're going to have to do. And there's a lot to it, because 85%, like you said, of bankruptcies are for medical expenses. Mm-hmm. And long-term care, that's another secret in my book, that is a nightmare that people just don't think about. 7 out of 10 people over 65, and it's something like 3 or 4 under 65 end up in a nursing home. Why? They have a rule in the hospital called the DRG rule, which means get you out of there as soon as possible. They don't want you there more than 3 days because they get less money. So if I break my leg skiing, guess where I'm going? To a nursing home. It's not an age-driven system anymore. It isn't just all the 90-year-olds go to a nursing home. It's all of us that don't qualify for that recovery in hospitals.
Can you tell me one more time the website where they can get the workbook and how to get in touch with you?
My website's www.readyforpretirement. That's readyforpretirement.com. You can call me at 951-926-4158, and I'm going to offer all your listeners a financial fitness review, and I normally charge $197 today. I'm not going to charge for your listeners, but they must say the name and your name of the show, right, to be able to get that offer. And what I do is look at what you have, where it is. Grab the workbook, text 777-47s to 22828, and you can email me at Chris, K-R-I-S, at readyforpretirement.com, and we'll set you up for a financial fitness review.
That's awesome. I think most of us do need that, of course. And don't forget to mention Boomerology Review. It's the name of the show. I am Shahar. And, you know, we need to talk about difficult topics. And money many times is a difficult one. But if we as boomers want to live forever, we need to be ready and have money to enjoy that.
If you are diabetic like me, or maybe you have arthritis, or even if you're a pregnant mother, you really want to pay attention to the product I'm going to show you. It's a lot more than a product, it's a system. It's the FootMate system. One piece of the system is this brush. You know, you can use this brush in your shower or in your bathtub. It has soft bristles here for the tender places in your feet, and stiffer bristles right here that takes away all the dry skin and rough areas. But that's not only what makes the system. We also have the rejuvenating gel. The rejuvenating gel is composed of tea tree oil or melaleuca, aloe vera, and conditioning. And as we all know, tea tree oil and aloe vera are fantastic for healing skin, and they take away also the odor. So even if you have some sports fan inside your home, you might want to try the systems with them. Now, like I said, you can use in the shower or in your bath. The system has suction cups that you can put to any smooth surface and use it there, either on the walls of your bed or on the floor. If you don't have a smooth surface, you just need to put one foot on one side while you brush the other, so you're always safe. FootMate system is really great, especially if you have diabetes, arthritis, you're a pregnant mother having a hard time reaching your feet, and of course, athletes that need to take that odor out. You can find FootMate at footmate.com. Here I want to show how advertising can actually be the same catering to what has changed in one generation. This is a fantastic example actually by P&G with Oil of Olay. You see here on my left that we have this ad 40 years ago with a woman and talking about the splendor of your skin, the drive to try to look perfect. And you can see that she's looking in a way that in advertising was considered a way to be attractive to men. And even the way she's looking is called the male gaze. So a way to look and say, hey, I'm pretty. And all about her is about perfection. So the blonde, the white, flawless skin here. And it's all about being perfect so you can attract the men in your life. Now, let's fast forward 40 years, and here is exactly the same product and how we have it. So now the model, you can see that she's in, you could say the same pose, but now she's looking straight at you, defying you even. It's not a perfect model, and now they chose a brunette. And it's not about hiding the flaws, but showing the best of who I am. And the logo, instead of the splendor of your skin, which was before about perfection, it is about I will not let age change me, I will change the way I age, which is very aligned with baby boomers that want to change every phase of their life and find a unique way to live that moment. So it's very interesting because it's exact the same product, and you could say exact the same ad, but now with the approach that resonates with us baby boomers, the female baby boomers. They also, as a marketing trick, they used a new ingredient called olivine, which is nothing else but, of course, oil of olive, of oil of olay. So exactly the same product, just with a twist. But what's really important, how we see ourselves today in society. We are not about being perfect, we are not about being flawless, but we are about controlling the moment we live and taking the best we can out of it. So fantastic, fantastic advertising to show us as a generation how we have evolved in the last 40 years.
I hope you enjoyed the show this week. If you did, don't forget to share, thumbs up, rate our channel. These are the type of things that keep us going. And I'll meet you next week at Boomerology Revealed.